Kirsten O'Brien.
He is Mark Speight, and together
we are smart.
Kirsten, tell me, have you got everything for our fun-based art frolics today?
Ooh, let's just check, shall we? Have we got our smartest?
I'll take that as a yes.
Have we got a top celebrity guest?
Hold on, I'll just check.
Stephanie McIntosh, aka Sky from Neighbours, are you here?
Yes, I am.
Will she then?
There's still something missing, though, isn't
there? Oh, that would be all-American, uber-cool guy and all-round Fischetti person. Yes, you know the one, don't you? Yes, him, Mr. Mike Fischetti!
Yay! Ah, that's it then, we're sorted. Let these art-based frolics, as you call them, begin.
Yes.
Would you tell them what's coming up?
I certainly will. I'll just get out of vision first.
I'll be showing you how to draw a fantastic 3D robot. Kirsten goes all rock chick to see how music affects your art rate. And my mum pops in to make art out of tights and socks. I wonder if I'll see her.
It's that part of the show where we like to make something American. So if we're going to make something American, we need an American to make it, don't you think?
Yeah.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I am indeed. Let's get on the phone to Justin Timberland's agent.
No, you chimp. Mike Fischetti needs to
do it.
Yeah.
Listen, now you're an American, you're Miss America, or you're Miss America, whichever takes your fancy. And you make American things to cheer you up. So what in the name of all things American are you going to make for us today?
Whoa, deep breath, Mark. First things first, will you please roll my titles?
Yeah! Mike's American Dream.
America, what American thing are you going to make this time?
Today, controversially, I'm not going to make something, but I'm going to make someone.
Oh.
He is one of the most famous Americans alive today. Kirsten and Mark.
Yeah.
Today, I'm going to make David Beckham!
Beckham.
Hang on a minute, Mike. He's British.
Was British. I looked him up. He lives in LA now, okay?
Yeah!
Oh, fair enough. So you mean the same Beckham who recently signed for LA Galaxy for £128 million. The same Beckham that wears a new pair of $300 boots each game. He suffers from a taxophobia, that's a fear of disorder. That Beckham.
I didn't even know that, Kirsten, but yeah, that's the one I'm talking about. David Beckham.
I've never heard of him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you've got your smartest. You've got to pick two. You've got six.
Two.
Who's it going to be?
Let's go. Let's take a look.
Only two out of this lively bunch
right
there.
And, was it two? Yeah, three looks good. I like three.
Very shouting.
And three. I choose three. And
what about two?
All the way at the end? Six is perfect. Six at the end. Three and six.
Okay,
Fischetti, you've got your smartest.
Yes, I do.
You better go do it.
All right, smartest, come on.
Go back.
Good luck.
So, Kirsten, tell me, how do you make your pasta faster?
You can get quick cook stuff. Cooks quite fast, twice as fast.
Really? No, I was thinking full steam ahead. Thank you.
No, you don't steam it, you boil it. That's where you're going wrong with your dinners, isn't it?
Right, should we just crack on? Now, we're going to make a pasta picture. The reason why we're using pasta is because it comes in so many different shapes and sizes.
Look at them all.
And it's great fun to play around with. Now, we've got some discs here of cardboard. We're going to stick them straight onto it. So,
look at those, like, tiny ones you've got there.
What have you got, actually? What's that one called?
That's a mini farfalle tonde. Do you want
to get
some
glue off? You completely threw me there. Right, put some glue down for you. I'll dish out the glue, some PVA. Okay, a little bit on there, like that.
And then just arrange them in a shape?
Yep, absolutely.
Okay. The brownish ones, they are not...
Streets ahead of me, Kirsten.
Because I haven't got sausage fingers.
Right.
Look, I'm just arranging that in a lovely little
wheel shape.
The last thing I'm going to put in is in the centre there.
Okay, you've actually done really well.
Need to leave that to dry
now.
You don't want to watch us waiting for those to dry. So
I haven't quite grasped that one. Okay, but we have got some that are dry over here,
luckily,
which are ready to paint. And we've got some enamel paint, which is actually non-toxic, so it's still safe to use. Okay, now put
the
dot.
Give it a good stir. That's the trick with this stuff, isn't it?
Yeah, no, that's right. And the good thing with this paint is actually it sticks onto the pasta because it's got quite a sort of a shiny surface.
There we go.
Yeah, and whatever you do, don't cook the pasta first because you'll be in a right mess. Or don't try and eat it afterwards. Sorry, I'm just taking the obvious. Right, anyway, okay, here we go.
Are you feeling the need to keep talking?
I don't know why it is actually. Yes, I do. Because it's. So I just crack on and.
Yes,
and yeah, okay.
Could you?
Okay, so.
Can you see, though, how shiny the paint is?
It's enamel paint. It's brilliant for that. It's like for model making. But look, we've got some here that are already dry. Look. And the result is amazing. Isn't that lovely? Look. It looks metallic.
It does, doesn't it? Now, that looks quite boring as a picture, doesn't it?
It does indeed. Yeah, we do need the rest of the picture, which is, in fact, a train. Mike, where are you? Sorry.
Here we go.
There he is.
Look
where you going for
that.
A minute. Look at the work that's gone into this, because there's a lot of work gone into this picture. And there's lots of different types of pasta. But it looks amazing. I think it looks fantastic.
Let's add that final wheel on there, like that. We've got a bit of penne on there, some fusilli as well. And can you pass those? I think they'll make a perfect finishing touch.
Oh, I don't know what these were for, actually.
These are sort of noodly things. You can even use some noodly
things. But look, that's the range of steam.
Painted white, look.
Look, isn't that beautiful?
Hey, isn't that great? And you can really experiment because, believe it or not, that picture behind us there is all pasta, but works really well in just one colour, doesn't it? Really, really shiny.
Lovely. I love that. Great stuff. OK, so why don't you have a go at making some pasta pictures?
So what's that one called again?
Mamma Mia.
We all know that music affects the way we behave. For example, some music can make you feel like getting physical. Some music can make you feel like dancing. And some music can make you feel like relaxing. Music affects your moods, and it's all to do with what's going on in your head. So to prove this, I've come to the Royal Hospital for Neurodisability to meet Barb Davison, who's a music therapist working in neurology. When you listen to a piece of music, your brain is stimulated and it sends messages throughout your body. If you listen to an upbeat song, your brain releases chemicals called endorphins, which make you feel good. But if you listen to a sad song, your brain will release other chemicals which could make you feel down. Ah, Barb Davison, excellent. Barb, is it true that music affects your mood?
Yeah, there's no doubt. Music does affect your mood.
Thank you. So, music affects your mood, but how does it affect your art? To find out, I'm going to need a DJ. Hey, DJ Kev.
Hello.
I'm going to need tons of dancers. Hi, people.
Hello.
And I'm going to need loads of art stuff. Ah, cunning. So I've got three blank canvases. I'm going to make three different pictures. Who knows what Kev is going to play? So who knows how it'll affect my mood? In fact, there is only one way to find out. DJ Kev, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Hey, why don't you guys party while I get arty, eh? Party, party. Oh, just play the record, Kev. This tune. Nice vibrant colours. It's a bit like a funky cityscape at this point, isn't it? Change colour! This is quite calming. I'm doing gentle brush strokes for starters, but quite thick, gloopy ones, so I've got a bit of a plan. Ooh, the music's changed. Now that's even calmer, isn't it? What about pretty flowers? colours are perfect. That was great fun. Look at the finished results. The first tune was very poppy, so that made me feel kind of jumpy, bouncy, alive, and all of these kind of movements were made with the bouncing up and down. Lots of bright colours there as well, really leaping out of the paper at you. Then onto the classical tune, which chilled me out a little bit. I went for kind of calmer, bluer colours, and the water just kind of gently pouring down. Then it kind of had a pace change, so I then started swirling the colour in, like that, merging all of those yellows and purples to make those pretty flowers. Well, from that to the heavy rock, thick black on there, loads of luminous colours just thrown onto the paper, all finished off with big splats of poster paint. So it's true, music really does affect your mood, and your mood affects your creativity. Actually, all this jumping up and down has got me in the mood for a party. Do you fancy it?
Yeah!
Excellent stuff, Kev, move out the way. I know how to get this party started. That's it, you want a party?
Yeah!
Woo! Have a bit of that!
Barbie, let's go,
yes, that's the one, isn't it, everyone? Woo! What's your move? Do the... Wait, no, wait, where are you going? No, come on! We're doing the... Where are you going? Woo-hoo! Fischetti makes something American, but this time he has bent the rules, a little like this guy might bend a free kick, because he's going to attempt to make, yeah, see that?
I like that.
The ex-Leytonstone and ex-England captain, now of LA Galaxy soccer player, David Beckham. That's the
David
only time
Beckham.
I'm saying.
Heck yeah! Give me a heck
best
yeah!
Heck yeah! Selected smartest though, he's got James, he's got Charlotte, you're going to do it in 5 American minutes?
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah. We're confident!
Okay, Mikey, let's do this. Remember, if you fail, there's going to be a penalty. Ooh. Are you ready? You've got 300 stateside seconds in 3, 2, 1.
Go! Okay, you guys know what you're doing? Get started. I'm going to go over here. First things first, I'm going to draw out David Beckham. Now, if you look over there, what they're doing, we've got James pouring pink paint into the paint roller tray so that we can use that later. And I think, Charlotte, are you sorting out the popcorn?
Yeah.
Yeah, good. I should be drawing, I don't know why I'm talking. Okay, I need to draw his face so we know where we're going with this.
Whose face, Mike?
David Beckham!
You said it right!
You know what? David Beckham is actually really easy to draw because he's really symmetrical. All his features are quite well defined and symmetrical. So let's go in there, yep. Oh, let's find a nose. Got a nose?
Yeah.
Almost ready? PVA glue! Lots of glue. We need all that glue in there. You better hurry up.
Okay.
How are we doing on time? I think we got plenty of time on this. Yep.
4 minutes, Michael.
Oh,
4 minutes.
Plenty of time. This is going to be
just
great.
Just ask me.
Come on with that glue. Almost ready? Okay. All right.
More glue!
Now I know that... Come on with that glue. Woo! Yeah, go ahead. Can you guys bring it over? Yep, great. All right. Good.
Put it down.
Okay, so now we know where we're going. Oh, yep, pretty good, pretty good.
Gluing.
Woo, we need rollers.
Yeah.
Come over here, I gotta show you something, Lelia. This is pretty cool. Now, technically,
minutes,
I know Beckham is British. But what makes this American is that A, he does live in LA now, and that's in America.
Yeah.
And B, we're using one of America's favorite foods, corn. We got popcorn, got corn on the cob, and my own personal invention, yes, my invention, corn on the roller! Yeah! That's good! Let's go! I'm gonna get some more glue. Yep, oh, good pink paint, that's perfect. I'm gonna take all this over here.
3 minutes, Mikey!
And we're just gonna load it up with it. Oh, glue all around the edge, because that's where we're gonna put the green popcorn. Now, I dyed this popcorn in my house. It took me 8 hours to dye this popcorn. I am serious. My house still smells badly. Okay.
It does anyway.
All I did, though, to do it was I took green food coloring, and then I baked it in the oven for another 8 hours, and I got loads of it. I just ripped that. Okay, keep going. How you doing over here, Charlotte? You're doing great. Get the pink. We need loads of pink. I need another. Let's get a roller. Get another roller. Here we go.
It's coming up.
Oh, that's okay. Do it. Two at a time. Here we go. Lots of it. slap it on here. You know what? This roller actually, because the way it comes off in like little dots, it actually kind of looks like a Roy Lichtenstein kind of painting. You know, because he was like a pop artist and he did like his Bende dot comic strip art kind of stuff.
2 minutes, Mikey!
Anyway,
it's cool. Come on!
Look it up later.
Get on with it!
Okay, okay, I'll stop talking! All right, well, let's start with the popcorn, I think. Yep, start with that green. You keep going with the pink. We haven't even gotten close here. Chuck it on, like bucket loads, Charlotte. Just keep going. We gotta go quickly now.
Come on!
Come on!
Go, Charlotte!
Come on! Get it on there. I'm gonna need some more paint. Yep, loads. Pour it. Pour the whole bucket on there. That's what I'm talking about. Okay. We got plenty of time left. How much time is left? Oh, minute 25, someone says out loud. Okay, I want to do some features. I need some glue. I got it all over me. Okay, we need that black. Where's that black, Charlotte?
Yep.
Black. Can I hand it over here? Okay. Thanks. Oh, get the blonde out. Yep. Blonde. Come on. This is where it goes crazy. Every time I think I have enough time. Every time. Get some blonde on there. Get some on here.
I'm trying to do this.
Come on, James, pour this blonde on this hair. Get the hair. Get the hair. Yeah, that's good. Black. Eyes. I gotta put the eyes in here. I gotta need loads of black. Where's the red? I need the red for the lips. Get it in here. Pour it on here. Who cares? I've totally messed that up.
30 seconds.
Get it on there. How much time is left? 35. We need to get it up. That's okay. Let's go. Help me out here.
Come on, I'm coming.
Oh, it's going to rip. I know it. Come on.
Remind you of David Beckham, James?
Sort of.
Charlotte?
Yes.
You're happy with
He's
that?
Melting. He's melting.
Okay, I quite like the dropping thing. I'm a popcorn fan, so I would probably give you the thumbs up, but okay. It's not what I think. You know this every week. First up, we have to ask the smartest, is it a pass?
Come on, I know.
It's a fail, smartest.
Remember what it looked like before we put it up.
Uh-oh. They've gone fail. It's a fail from the smartest.
Not a good start.
It's not over yet.
Come on, Diggy.
Our researcher, what are you going for, Diggy?
Come on.
She's past you.
She's on my team.
Hang on, it could go either way now. There is one.
Come on, David Beckham.
Beckham. David Beckham.
He is no longer American. Kick him out. He's
fail.
Back.
Hold on, just one second.
Does that mean I failed?
I'm so sorry, Mikey. It's an American Pie moment, which means you're going to have to try next time much, much harder.
Great.
Loser.
Time for Smart Now. For me, Mark Speight, when I prove to you that anybody can draw. And joining me, I've got two smartest, so I have Maisie and Joe. Yay! Now, guys, as artists, out of 10, what do you like at drawing? 10 being brilliant.
I'd say I'm about a 7 out of 10.
A 7? Well, very good. And Maisie?
7.5.
7.5! Oh, I like that. OK, and on the webcam, all the way from Glasgow, we have Siobhan. Siobhan, hello, fruit. Now, are you a good artist or are you average? All right, two whistles and a clunk. I take that as you're pretty good. I'm talking to R2-D2, can you believe it? Okay, now, actually, have you got your pen and pencils ready?
Yeah.
Good. Now, this is quite amusing. The other day, somebody stopped me and said, "Good day, sport, can you draw a 3D robot?" And I said no. Not because I can't, because at the time I was bungee jumping off the Sydney Harbour Bridge. It's not a gag, it's a fact. I'm telling you. Anyway, let's crack on, shall we? Get your pencils out and draw me the letter A, OK? A big capital A, so like this. This is what we're going for. Something like that, OK? And the top of your A should be about three quarters of the way up. Say about there. OK, lovely. That's it. That's all you need to do to make your robot. No, I haven't finished yet, by the way. Now, I want you to imagine you're a tiny little worm and you're looking up at this huge robot, a giant robot, OK?
Okay, so I want to get your pens out now, okay? Got your pens? Got your pen, Siobhan? Bless you. Right. Okay, now start at the very top. This is his head, okay? So we're doing a head here. We'll do some little horns like that, okay? Just make it look a bit more sinister. And that's his body. We'll work it down, okay? Basically, we're just building the body up like so. Now, these arms are going to come slightly past where the letter A starts like that, okay? And that's the arms. Let me just darken those a little bit. This now becomes his tummy, okay? You can see what's happening there. You see it's getting bigger and bigger as it comes towards us. Now, these lines here act as his legs, so let's just separate them a little bit like that. Another one down there like that. And let's do some big old boots on him, okay? Now, I'm not sure what you call that shape, because I'm not a very good mathematician, but it's a something shape, yes. You see, a boot shape. There you go. Let's just put a line across there. So what we want to do now is put a little panel on his tummy like so, okay, with some buttons and dials and whatever. Let's make those spikes in his shod. Let's put some rivets on him. You see some little dotty rivets? They look really good to make it look a bit more metallic, okay? And some reflective stripes down here just to give it a metal sheen, okay? Now, of course, the trick is to spend a bit more time and add a bit more detail, and you can really go to town and make your robot look absolutely wonderful. But I'm very, very happy with this particular chap. Okay, Smartest, can we have a look at your 3D robots? Oh, Joe and Maisie, genius! Aren't they lovely? And Siobhan, can I have a look at your 3D robot, please, madam? Let's have a look. Oh, beautiful! Oh, that's fantastic, you see? Now, why don't you have a go at drawing a 3D robot? It's easy and it's fun. More art from me, Mark Speight, next time. Thank you.
Still to come on Smart. Everyone needs good neighbours, and we've got the best one. Yep, Stephanie McIntosh is in the house. We'll show you how to make some art to take away and find out if your work's made it into this week's gallery. Now, a wise man once said, if you aim for the sky, you reach the top of the trees. Well, we've done better than that. We have reached the sky. Give her a Smart welcome, please. It's Stephanie McIntosh.
All righty.
Hello. Nice to see you.
Oh, Steph, you are lovely. Oh, now, are you up to play our arty game?
Okay, sure.
Well, basically, what we've done is brilliant, right? Because you are known as Sky in Neighbours, mm-hmm. We've created an ingenious game. It's called Reach to the Sky.
Oh, my you like it, God. Yeah.
Basically, there are three sky-themed pictures. Your job is to work out what the name of the picture is and who it's by.
Yeah, but we're only going to show you a teeny-weeny bit of the sky, okay?
Uh-oh, okay.
Is that all right?
Are you ready to play Reach for the Sky?
I'm ready to reach for the sky.
Oh, bless you.
Have a little look. Okay. Picture number one, what do you think that is? Where's that sky from?
Wow, that's
come
amazing.
Come on, you must know.
Come on, Steph.
Jeez.
Come on,
thinking,
crack on.
I'm thinking, you know, because of his masterpieces, maybe a bit of, you know, Ralph Harris.
But a Ralph Harris.
Ralph Harris.
No. It's actually Houses of Parliament by Monet. You were very close.
Very close.
They're on the
very
par,
close.
They're on the par, very, those artists. Let's reach for the sky the second time.
Okay.
Have a look.
Oh.
There's a clue in there.
It's not a penguin.
I don't know if I recognise that forehead at all. Da Vinci?
Oh, yep, yeah, keep going.
Absolutely right, it's the Mona Lisa.
Oh, very good.
You're your sky, but what about this final bit of sky for you now? Let's reach for the sky one last time. Who is the artist and what is the painting called?
It's pretty tough.
That is seriously tough.
Nothing coming to mind?
Nothing's
loose.
Oh, that is a shame.
Bouncer?
It's actually called Kai by up-and-coming artist Smartest Theo.
Oh, it's amazing.
Yes.
She did say with her teacher. Oh, God, look,
I'm
man.
Still scratching my head. That's okay.
Don't worry, I do it all the time. Flaky scalp. Anyway, now we know you as an actress from Neighbours, but you're also a very successful singer. Can we take a look at you in action?
Okay, cool. Thanks, yeah.
It was unreal. Sydney is beautiful, and the exhibition was awesome.
Anything else?
The weather. It was great. It was sunny and humid.
I'm talking about the weather, Scott.
Very good.
Hang on a second.
reality TV star. Anything you can't do?
Well, actually, I'm not very good at pottery.
That's unfortunate because the next item is actually the celebrity potty challenge.
No, I'm not. I can't do it. I've never done it.
Contractually, you have to.
You're going to have to, I'm afraid.
Get on.
Come on. Let's track on.
Stephanie McIntosh, a.k.a. Speight.
Hey!
Potty Celebrity Challenge. Take a seat. Okay, we're not going to get any clay on that lovely dress. You've got your clay there. You've got 2 minutes to attempt to make a pot. Mike is here to help you out.
We can do it.
So far, we have had the good. Have a little look at that. That's the Weasley twins' effort there. We've had the bad as well. That's little Chris's pot.
Bless.
And we've had the Rossley.
Ouch. Pathetic.
What was going on there?
Whoa, shocking.
So
a
mixed bag of effort, really.
Great.
I don't know how you're going to fare with those lovely shoes on, though. Look at that. Woo!
Oh, love.
Lovely.
I do like that.
Might help you with that.
Stephanie, we'd like you to try and recreate this.
Whoa!
Do you get those down, hey. Under, mate? Do you get those
right.
down?
Oh, we can do it.
Is that a dog?
It is a dog, yes.
Okay. I'll be asking you questions as well. 2 minutes. Assume the position.
Lots of things to concentrate on.
Okay. Yeah, good luck.
Okay.
And you're off!
A dog.
Go for it, Steph.
Start the wheel. Stephanie.
Yep.
Get some
cup your hands first,
it.
I would.
Yeah, cup your hands around it.
Oh,
cupping
a bit of...
Oh, yeah.
Whoa. Yeah! Not too much gas.
How do I slow it down?
She hasn't got too much control in the heels here.
Start driving on the milk flow.
Slow it down, yes.
That's it.
Have you ever driven the milk flow?
Oh, now we've gone from the ridiculous
that's good.
To the sublime now.
A bit more. Speed it up just a bit. Speed it up just a bit. There you go.
Yeah. Hey, that's good. That's good. That's really good.
Just leave it.
Really,
just
really
leave it.
Like
just
now,
like
just hang on to it. Hang on in there.
Yeah.
I'd quite like to ask you a question. Neighbours or Home and Away? Stephanie.
Oh, Home and Away, always.
No. What else? Oh, I've thought of a good one. Where does Kylie buy her kebabs?
Yes.
In Jason's Donovan!
Very good.
Concentrate, look.
You're making a point.
That joke was just so good, I can stop laughing.
Here we go.
No, that's good. You're just melting down the inside.
I'm just going to try and get the nose going now, you know?
Oh, I see.
Don't worry too much. You know, I mean, it's not... Just try and get a bowl. I mean, the bowl is really what you're aiming for. This is just a little bit of a gimmick.
Maybe just try to flatten the inside.
Flatten the inside, okay. We're really getting a good... Can you see? Okay.
Yeah, just hold on to that.
Okay.
Yeah,
woo!
Yeah. Not bad so far.
Yeah, it's looking good. That's looking really, really good.
Have you ever eaten kangaroo?
No.
Less gas.
Okay.
Yeah, try to flatten
it out. Oh, no!
It's a pancake. Can you...
Definitely.
It's a plate. Go for the plate.
Try to curl up the inside.
Okay, I'm just going to stop it.
Yeah, that's it. Okay. Let's have a quiet moment, everybody.
We're just going to have a quiet moment. We're just going to have a... Stop.
She's trying to get her.
Looking too ripper, mate.
Yeah, I know.
She's going to that up.
I'm a bit bonza.
Thanks, mate.
Look.
Oh, no, mate.
Now...
Six, five, four, three, two, one.
Yeah! Well done, Steph. Dear. That's what you're aiming for.
Yes! You might have to just bang that on the barbie.
There you go.
Look at the
You can hold that up. Try to hold that
Okay,
up.
I'm going to hold my beautiful dog.
Look at that. Everybody, let's give it up for Stephanie's Cornish pasty!
Time for a bit of recycled art now. You'll definitely want to peas at the action because I'm going to do some pizza printing right now.
Oh, pizza printing, fantastic! Now, that's what I call art. Look at that. Fantastic.
No. I mean using the base that comes with a frozen pizza.
Right, OK. Mark contributes nothing. Mark exits shot.
Right, now that's got rid of him. These are the bases. They're kind of polystyrene, come with a frozen pizza, as I said. And you can see here, I've just kind of done a bit of a design on there. And all I'm going to do, using a blunt pencil, is just press on. So you're not going all the way through. You're just trying to do an indentation like that, pressing on. Let's just mark that. There we go. Sometimes you need to go over it a few times just to make sure you've definitely got a groove going on. So you can see the pattern starting to come together, can't you? But it's going to take me a wee while to do all of that. So there's one that just needs a little bit of finishing off here right now. See, it's almost done. I think I'll just put a bit of a circle type thing in there, and then maybe just some. It's quite nice to do your pencil point in, like that, very easy technique. Now you're ready to start painting this. So I've got poster paint in here and a mini roller. Just load it up and then just roller it onto your design. Lovely, yes. You could just do one colour or you could mix all your colours up and blend them, but the trick is to make sure the paint is getting into those grooves. I'm going to be sort of quite neat on my edges, I think, there. Unusually for me. Right, I think I'm ready to print. Dun, dun, dun. Let's get the paper on there. Now, this doesn't always work, but sometimes it's part of the fun if it comes out sort of a bit wobbly. Press it on. Oh, no! It moved a little bit then. I think this may be a disaster, but stick with it. Press on. Beat it. Here we go. Now, a bit of a tip. If you use them over and over again, they do start to get clogged with paint, so you don't want that to happen. Let's see what's happened to mine. Yes! Look at that. A lovely design.
Beautiful.
And don't panic if you don't even like pizza, because you can use different bits of fast food boxes. You see that there? That lovely block picture that's been done? That was made using a burger box, or sometimes jacket potatoes come in these, don't they? Like that. And you see this amazing one here, the hot pink picture, simply made by doing the same thing onto a polystyrene cup.
Beautiful.
Isn't it perfect? Now, where did Speighty go with that pizza? I'm famished.
Hey, Mark. I really like these moments, just me and you, mano a mano.
Oh, cheers, Mike.
Hey, lads, lads, lads.
Thanks.
Guess what? A delivery man's just rocked up trying to deliver us a case of fake tan. I said, on your bicyclette, none of us wear fake tan. You all right?
Yeah, fine. I've just got to go and pick up a delivery of Dundee cake. Yeah,
right. Oh. What's up with him?
I don't know. I love Dundee cake, though. Mm.
Gary! Oh, hello, Michael. Up it, Christine. Oh. Sorry. Did I say up and I meant to say hello, puppet?
Hi,
have you seen our Mark?
Well, he's just...
Michael, guess where I've just been.
Hi, Mrs. Speight. I can't really guess.
The beauty parlour.
You probably thought I was Cheryl Tweedy, didn't you?
No.
Anyhow, I've had my leg shaved.
I knew it was you.
Oh, goodness.
No, my stockings have fallen down. I'm so embarrassed, Michael. Oh! That gives me a smart idea! Look, now, what I thought we'd do, we'd have a go at making tight teddies. That teddy bear's made from tights. It just so happens we've got a bag full of them. How convenient. So, Michael, there's some stuffing for you. I'll put in a little bag for you. And there's some stockings. I've got one for you.
All right.
And I've got one for Christine over here. Now, so all you've got to do is to stuff all the extra tights into your stockings, you see, so it's nice and packed.
Okay.
Oh, thank you. There. Now, I knew it was going to take forever. So on the bus, I made some body parts just to speed things up a little bit. What have we got in here? Look, I've got some arms and legs, you see, and I've got a little body there. Isn't that, look, that's what we're aiming for, you see.
Oh,
look.
That's what you're aiming for, right? Oh.
Ignore her. Ignore her.
I guess you don't need that.
No, don't worry. Okay. Bless you, bless you. We tried so hard. Now, when you've got your body all stuffed, then you make your little arms, make a little savoy if you like, and then tie it round its neck, okay? Nice and tight. That's it, lovely. Here we go. Look at that. That's his arms, you see? And his legs. His legs. We just stretch you over like so, wrap it around his neck. Oh, that's it. Look, we've got a little... Hold there. And there you see, it all comes together nicely. When you flip it over, look at that. Isn't he sweet?
Yeah. Oh, that looks like a scarf there.
Oh, a little scarf to keep him warm. Now, I've got some elastic bands going to make some little ears. It's a bit fiddly, but do hang. Oh, no, I've tied them together.
Oh, you've got sausage fingers like your Mark.
Oh, will you stop it and have a look for elastic band? Make yourself useful. Anyway, you just make some little ears and just tie them round like that, you see.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Oh, there you go. That's lovely smashing. Well done. There, and you should just tie it round here like this. Oh, I'm getting a bit of a flush. I think it's all this excitement. There you go. There's his little ear, you see? Look, isn't he lovely? Aww. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Now we've got to draw a little face. Sorry. Oh, me back. Give us a shove, Michael. Me back's gone again. Oh, thank you, love. Here we go. Little face on him there. Little nose and a little mouth. There we are. Look. There.
Aww.
Isn't he sweet? Look. It's a little tight teddy. He's lovely. He's a little bit cheap and cheerful, but I think that'll suit you down to the ground, won't it, Christine?
Thanks.
Michael, I've made one for you out of old socks. Look.
Really?
Yes, there, but look at him. He's the sweetest thing there.
Are these Mark socks?
They are, darling, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, Mrs. S, it's quite soft, this. It's quite a nice gift. Thank you.
Oh, will you grow up? There's nothing to get excited about. Listen, anyway, I've got to go. Do tell Mark I popped in, won't you?
Okay.
Oh, bless you. Oh, Christine, you like recycling, don't you?
Oh, yes, I do.
Yeah, we'll recycle that.
Oh, bye, Mrs. S. Oh.
Hey, guys. Oh. You all right?
Yeah, we're all right. Whoa, you all right? You're looking a bit
pinky.
I've just been applying some Dundee cake. Hang on, I used to have a teddy like that when I was little. Has my mum been around?
Yeah. Oh,
great.
What's it like in New York City? I'm 1,000 miles away, but girl, tonight you look so pretty. Yes, you do. Times Square can't shine as bright as you. I swear it's true. Hey there, Delilah, don't you worry about the distance. I'm right there if you get lonely. Give this song another listen. Close your eyes. Listen to my voice, it's my disguise. I'm by your side. Oh, it's what you do to me. 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 What you do to me. Hey there, Delilah. Times are getting hard, but just believe me, girl, someday I'll pay the bills with this guitar. We'll have it good. We'll have the life we knew we would. My word is good. Oh, it's what you do to me. Oh, it's what you do to me.
In our gallery there. If you want to see more artwork, head online, bbc.co.uk/CBBC. And if that inspires you, why not send us your pictures? Smart, PO Box 5053, London W12 6AW. And if it's advice you want, well, here are Art Tip Monkeys.
Welcome to the Art Tip Monkeys.
Who are you?
I'm Steve's replacement. He's entered School Monkeys Come Dancing.
Good riddance.
He's danced with that monkey from Blue Peter.
Mabel?
I'm sure they called him Gethin.
If you're Jerome, then who's he?
Who, me? That's me cousin, Keith. What did you say?
Here's tip 114.
That's my line.
To rescue brushes that have gone hard, just soak them in vinegar and they'll be back to normal.
Who's back in Cornwall?
Give me strength.
These brushes are all hard and crusty. Check this out, though. Woohoo! It really works. Thank you, Art Tip Monkeys. Now on Smart, time for something alternative. It's...
Life Swap?
No, Mike.
Hey, Michael Palin as a postman?
What's wrong with you two? The Alternative Art Challenge!
We know! Yes, we've split the teams in two, and in the green team we have Thea, Charlotte and Joe!
Thea is the team captain over there, and in the yellow team we've got Maisie, we've got James and team captain Josie!
Now, the aim of the game is to create a likeness of today's celebrity guest, but who is today's celebrity guest, I hear you cry?
Who is today's celebrity guest?
Mikey.
It's everyone's favourite neighbour, Stephanie McIntosh slash Sky.
Alrighty. Now, the team which Stephanie thinks has created the best likeness will win the much sought after Smartest Art Challenge trophy.
Lovely stuff. I like the way they'll win it, Mark.
Do you like
really
that? Got the hands as well.
It's alternative. So, guys, it means you have to create our likenesses using tape.
That reminds us of the artist Christo
and Jean-Claude.
You know, they famously wrapped the German Parliament building,
the Reichstag,
in 100,000 meters of fabric and 15,600 meters of rope.
It took 90 mountain climbers to fix it into place.
No way.
Way.
You know what? That's a bit like us creating a sculpture of Stephanie out of tape.
Well sort of.
Fascinating. Do you mind if we do this?
Let's crack on.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Let's go.
You hear this noise,
surf's up.
That means you're out of time.
Everyone okay, guys. Clear? Yes. Sorry, shall I?
Come on.
Yes, I will. Let's crack on then in 3, 2, 1. Go!
Get going.
Okay, yeah, get on.
Okay, good. Good work.
Okay, let's get some hair. Let's get some hair.
Here you go. Lift it together. Right, now let me.
Oh, you got some stuff on there.
Trying to create, right?
Oh, look,
the features.
Yep, yep, here we go,
Get the tapes on the goal.
Look, just some little balls. Come here, I'll do some little balls for you as well. Here we go.
I'll help with the hair.
That's it, just scrunch him up, scrunch him up. Don't worry.
Here we go. How's it going?
You've got to be
neat. You put that on,
I'm going to help over here.
You
want to go
blue
eyes?
Blue for the
blue eyes. Okay, we need some
more
blue.
Yeah, you've got to mould it in there.
That's a nice mouth.
Get going.
I'll do some eyes for you, okay?
Here we go. Here's a bow. You can use this for a bow.
Bigger eyes.
Put that on there.
We'll get a loads of hair. Stick it down. Just stick it down. You can. Come on. Just chuck it in the face.
Get a yellow tie.
Look
at
that. Beautiful.
Yellow tie.
That's lovely. That's good. That's good.
Here we go. Take that. You can use that for the tie.
More yellow. There you go.
That's a tie. Go put that on there.
Stephanie, come and join us.
Let's have a look.
Okay, well, we've got the tie, some eyes there, hair, the bow.
Okay, no, it is looking good, guys.
Steph, what do you think of the green teams?
Green teams.
You need some time to think.
This is a very tight competition, you see.
Come on, Steph.
Come on, Stephanie.
Oh, I hate this bit.
Well, this is a hard decision. I'm sorry, yellow team, it's the green team.
I knew you'd do it. I said you'd do it.
Bad luck, yellows. Well done, greens. Well done, all of our smartest today. Top fun, all of you. Stephanie, thanks for being here.
Thanks very much to our top lovely celebrity guest, Stephanie McIntosh, a.k.a. Sky.
We'll see you again real soon for more smart.
Smart. Bye.
Get ready for a prank invasion.
Yeah! This is Prank Patrol.
Prepare to be blown away.
That is your pass to prank.
The fully mechanical police officer.
They're back and bigger than ever.
Let's do it.
Prank Patrol starts Tuesday, 4:30, CBBC on BBC One.